So I'm sure by now most of you have already heard or seen about the Sith Trooper, which was officially unveiled the other day on all the Star Wars social media outlets. It's got an interesting name choice, I'll give it that. But I've got some mixed feelings regarding the design, and that it's basically a normal First Order Stormtrooper with a different paint job, some more detail on the armor, and an additional cut on the visor of the helmet. It's nice, but not something that I would say is groundbreaking. And if anything, it's kind of lazy when you compare it to all the new Imperial Stormtrooper designs that we've been getting. Those actually are unique designs from the ground up, rather than minor modifications made to the standard First Order Trooper design. With that said, the Red Stormtrooper idea isn't something new. In canon, the Galactic Empire had their own Crimson Stormtroopers, who were specially trained to operate in the heat of volcanic areas, and these guys were actually introduced in the Black Series collection under Disney. Meanwhile, the First Order had Captain Cardinal, who wore, and you guessed it, red First Order Stormtrooper armor. Basically the Sith Trooper armor, without all the detailing on armor like the Sith version has. Not to mention the First Order also had Elric Von Wreg, who was a First Order TIE pilot that wore special red armor. And as far as we know in canon, his design was unique only to him. And just the same, he piloted a red First Order TIE interceptor as well. So it's kind of like Disney have some kind of obsession in making the bad guys in Star Wars wear all red now or something. As for the Sith Trooper itself, originally we thought they were part of the Red Fury, which was a Stormtrooper legion of the First Order stationed on Batuu. But then it actually turned out that the Stormtroopers part of the Red Fury wore nothing but normal armor, which was kind of a bummer, I'm not gonna lie. However, there's something very interesting about the real Sith Troopers that were unveiled by Disney. For starters, on the toy packaging of the Sith Trooper, never once is the word First Order mentioned. Which is incredibly strange considering when you look at all the other First Order related toys, you always see First Order mentioned, then followed by the name of the actual trooper. Seriously, I dare you to find an official licensed First Order trooper toy that doesn't mention the name First Order on it. Guaranteed, you won't be able to find it. And to add to this, instead of the First Order emblem, we see some kind of completely new emblem used instead. Right now we've got no idea what this emblem is, but it is used in other Sith Trooper merchandise, especially in place of where the First Order emblem would have normally been used instead. This emblem also seems to be a symbol that only represents Darth Vader and Palpatine according to the recently unreleased canon book, Star Wars Who's Who in the Galaxy Character Storybook. So this got me thinking, seeing as based on the merchandise, trying to stray away from the First Order, and these guys being called Sith Troopers, of which obviously Kylo Ren isn't one and if anything wants to kill the past and not have anything to do with it, then it wouldn't surprise me if these guys actually work for Palpatine in some way, kind of like his own personal army to fight against the First Order. As not to go into spoilers too much, but we have seen some episode 9 leaks that do suggest that Kylo Ren is against Palpatine. So if anything, we could be seeing First Order Stormtroopers be fighting Sith Troopers in the Rise of Skywalker. Not to mention that the Sith Troopers are separated from the First Order on that grocery store poster of the Rise of Skywalker that got leaked a while ago. So that could very well mean something. And yeah, that poster is real, just not the official poster for the movie, but still part of the official movie merchandise. Either way, I thought this was pretty interesting and not something I've seen anyone else really talk about or mention. And if my theory does pan out to be true, then it would be pretty cool to see Kylo Ren and the First Order be fighting both the Resistance and Palpatine and his Sith forces in the Rise of Skywalker. Which would mean less boring slow capital ship chase scenes and more military action, which I would definitely be down for. But let me know down in the comment section if you like the design and if you think these guys are actually Palpatine's personal army, or if you think they are actually part of the First Order but Disney simply forgot to include the name and the emblem on the merchandise. Either way, I'm curious to see what you all think about this. As always, be sure to like and share this video, as well to keep it here to Silo for everything on the latest in Star Wars. N7 from Silo, signing out.